their child's life to grow and develop an understanding and a personal relationship with God. Your family and friends form a congregation and bless to help raise a child. We have come together today to welcome a new life, a child into the world, into our lives, but we have also come together to celebrate the miracle and mystery that is the center of life, the heart around which all things revolve, love. We each have been made the miracle of life that entered into the parents' lives. We have grown and been blessed by the warmth and tenderness of love from the parents and friends, and like the rosebud we have blossomed in the body, in the beauty of love, becoming our own unique selves. Amen. So now, a baby dedication is a special observe in worship and service for parents and pledge to raise a child in a Christian faith. Because raising a child in faith is not done independently, I recommend involving parents, godparents, and congregation in the church to help to each party recognize the responsibility in nurturing a child in faith. It's exciting whenever a new child enters a family, like Reg, Neva. This is the first baby of Reggie and Teresa, and there's no greater moment than parents sense that children are here from God. It says in Psalms 127, verse 3, "Behold, children are the heritage from the Lord, the fruit of the womb, a reward." Amen. So now, this is the service of the parents. Can you please stand up, Sister Teresa? Okay? Children are gift from God, right? Sister Teresa, as believers, because you believe in Jesus Christ and you believe that God has given you a child, as believers, you as believers, we are called to recognize that children belong first to God and foremost. God, in His goodness, gives children as a gift of parents. They are not only the responsibility of caring for the gift, but also the wonderful privilege of enjoying a gift. Because children belong to God and are given by the grace of gifts of parents. It's only proper and appropriate that children to be dedicated back to God. That's why Sister Teresa, it's the first thing na i-dedicate niya muna ang kanyang baby sa ating Panginoon bago umuwi sa Pilipinas. Napakaganda na in-honor nila, to honor God as to dedicate Reg Nathan to Jesus Christ. Amen. This is the dedication of biblical. In Matthew 13:5, it says here, the children were brought to Jesus. You see, even the children before, they brought to Jesus. So thank God for the life of Sister Teresa, because she knows Jesus and dinedicate niya ang kanyang anak una sa ating Panginoon. It says here, then but the disciples rebuke those who brought them. But Jesus said, let the children come to me, do not hinder them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these. He had placed his hand on him and he left him there. You know, Teresa, this is for parents and Reggie. Maybe Reggie is listening because the father is in Saudi Arabia. Dedicating your children, Sister Teresa, to the Lord is an acknowledgement that those children belong to God. And this belongs to God. Now, as you acknowledge that the child belongs to God, you accept the responsibility on behalf of God to bring up the child in discipline and his instruction to God. You have the responsibility na yan, papalakihin mo ang iyong anak kasama ang iyong asawa. Ibidiscipline mo yan. Baby pa lang yan, pinapanalangin mo na yan. Paglaki niya, anak, ganito ang magiging makuha mo sa school. Ganito ka. Marami ng discipline na ibinigay mo sa iyong mga anak. That's why sabi ng Panginoon, thank God, mothers and parents, na i-dedicate niyo una sa ating Panginoon. And then, it will follow. Nasabi niya sa Proverbs 22:6, train up a child in a way it should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. You know, from 1 first 3 or 2 weeks, dinala mo na si Reg Nathan dito sa church, nakapakinig na ng salita ng ating Panginoon, nakapag-praise and worship na. And that's the best, you dedicate your life to Jesus. It says here, the family is the divine institution to ordain of God from the beginning of time. So children are the heritage of the Lord, committed by Him to their parents for care, for this obligation and responsibilities, and make every effort to fully carry them out. In this act, the dedication, Reggie, Teresa acknowledge this responsibility and comes before us today to dedicate themselves to Reg Nathan and God's will for this life as a family. So thank God. So makikita natin, we have the godparents. What are the responsibilities naman ng godparents o ng ating mga sponsors? Ang responsibility ng sponsor ay hindi lang okay, nagbigay ka ngayon ng gift. No. But it is the continuation of your prayer. For example, Sister Teresa, nag-ask sa inyo ng mga godparents. Since kasi yung anak ko ganito, ganyan. Kasi ganito, need niya yung discipline. Need niya yung financial. Need niya ang pag-discipline sa kanya. Nandiyan kayo na godparents. So, thank God sa inyong lahat, godparents. May I honor the godparents? Can you please stand up, godparents, to come in front? Come in front to Sister Teresa. Lahat po kayo dito. Sister Teresa, dito ka. Sa gitna. Ayan. Ayan yung godparents. This is your responsibility as a godparents. In accepting this role, will you regularly pray for Reggie, Teresa, and Reg Nathan? I will repeat. In accepting this role as a godparents, will you regularly pray for Reggie, Teresa, and Reg Nathan?
Yes.
Amen. As close relatives, the 4 sisters and the family, we will conduct our lives in a way that reinforces the biblical values that Reg Nathan is taught in home, Sister Teresa. So parents have first the responsibility that parents need to help to support the godparents and new godparents. So I direct my question now to the church and to godparents. By being present at God's house today, do you hereby declare yourselves to be the children of God because you trust in Jesus Christ alone for the forgiveness of sin and the gift of eternal life? It is true. Please respond saying, we do.
We do.
Would you please stand, having come freely? I ask that you come the following commitment to those who stand before you, so that Reg Nathan may walk in abundant life that Christ offers. Do you vow by God's help to be faithful in the calling as members of the body of Christ? To the parents, to be faithful to God and to help teach and train Nathan in the ways to the Lord so that he might one day trust him as a Savior of Lord. If you accept this responsibility, please respond, we do. Amen. So, church, andyan kayo na godparents. I-dedicate ko na si Reg Nathan. Now we dedicate Reg Nathan, kayo mga godparents. You witness how to dedicate Nathan to the Lord. Hindi lang yung nandito kayo, Lord, tapos na yung responsibility ko. But no. You are going to train him. You are going to pray for him. To discipline him. To call him. When he grow up, makikita nyo ang kanyang paglaki sa Facebook. Tutulungan nyo siya. Diba? So, can we pray? Father in heaven, in the name of Jesus, Nathan as your son. Father, in the name of Jesus, Rich Nathan is the head and not the tail. And siya, Panginoon, ay karapat dapat na maging matalino, karapat dapat, Panginoon, na maging leader sa church, karapat dapat na maging honorable, Panginoon, sa family. Mataas ang honor niya sa school in the name of Jesus. Panginoon, I as the minister of Jesus Christ, I dedicate to Red Nathan of Lanao as a children of God. We come before you, Lord Jesus, at ikaw na, Panginoon, ay kaisa mo na sa kanyang buhay. Salamat, Panginoon. May I call Bishop Jopi to pray for Red Nathan?
Extend your hands. Extending the blessing to the Lord.
Amen. Yes,
God. Nathan means God is given.
Yes.
Siya po ay galing sa Diyos. He's a gift. He is a gift from the Lord.
Amen.
And because of that, allows everything will come to pass.
Yes.
In the last detail. And so, Lord, we continue to declare your blessing.
Yes.
You have already blessed him from the beginning,
yes,
even from the womb of the mother.
Yes.
Your blessings have already been poured out, and you will continue to pour out your blessing.
Yes.
Unique, special blessings, especially from the Lord. He is your creation. He is your special
man.
And in the name of Jesus, Lord, we pray, according to your promise, kapag ang po mga parents ay obedient to you, kapag po mga parents are God-fearing, everything about him, Lord, will be successful. It will be successful in every way. You will prosper. You will bless everything that he will put his hand to. You will open the windows of heaven in Christ Jesus for him. And when the time will come, when he will reach the age of consciousness, he will open his heart to Jesus. He will commit himself to the Lord Jesus. He will serve Jesus. Hallelujah. We give you praise. He will be an honor to the parents. He will be an honor to you. Hallelujah. He will not be a disgrace. He will not be a liability. He will be an asset. He will be a special blessing. He will be a special glory to the parents. Bringing more love and blessing to many people. In the name of Jesus, I speak all of these blessings, and they will be fulfilled in this life. From here on until the end. This is our prayer in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I declare. Everybody say,
Amen.
Invitation.
Amen.
And the guy, the Hebrew Chili, the Bizade. Aval, I mean, I need to Hebrew for them.
For them?
אני אומרת תודה רבה ובעל הבית שלי כועסה את לכם פה נתמולם סעד פגטדקורית פה סלמת פה סעינו לחד עלם נראה פה כמו סינו פה כיו and of course to the whole family of ECF amen kasama ko po kayo sa mga pagtatag ko sa buhay ngayon dito na po sa ako sa Israel and since I started coming in ECF kasama ko na po kayo so tala raba especially pastora tala raba ngayon gam the prayer warriors kinuha ko po kayo dahil alam ko naman na maibibigay nyo kay Reg Nathan ang spiritual support po sa kanya. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Especially pastoral, of course. And thank you kay nasan ba? Kay Sister Marnel ang aking Obigaine. Hindi ko alam kung ano ang tawag ko sa kanya, Obigaine, Obitora, Obalabacheli. Ano yun yun dat? Abal, kasama ko po siya sa matay anibera yun. Praise God. And super thank you po sa inyong lahat. God bless you all. And Bishop, thank you so much. Is yung pinakamaliit na words or comes from you ay alam kong napakalaking bagay sa Panginoon. Your prayer really helped us a lot. And especially nung mag-deliver po ako, tinext ko po siya. Tinext po ni Sister Tina and talaga namang express ang kanyang reply. Praise the Lord. Thank you po. At tinitignan po ako ng mga sisters. So thank you din po sa inyo. Dahil super supportive po ngayon, sisters. Praise the Lord. Nasaan na ba ako? Truly that God is faithful. And prayer really works. Amen. Praise the Lord. And without this happenings is only sa Panginoon lamang. Wala, hindi po naganap ito kung hindi sa Panginoon. Yeah. Praise God. At hindi po naganap ito kung wala po ang aking napaka-pogi Kamot Shetty San. Tino. Ben Shetty Kamot. And actually, de mitpalel Shelly anik ko last month omeret mitpalelet then anik ko last month omeret de Elohim do something great. I don't know how to say do some great testimony in my life, Lord, lagi kong sinasabi sa Panginoon. At pumunta pa ako sa Jerusalem, sa Wailing Wall, na talaga naman pagkataas-taas na aking naman doon. Para imag-pray noong na mabuntis po ako. And sabi ko sa inyo, prayer really works.
Amen.
Praise God. Thank you, Lord. At alam niyo po, sobrang nakita ko yung pagkilos ng Diyos sa buhay ko. And ay talagang napaka-organized. At talagang chichak, di ba? Chichak. Praise the Lord. So, kung talagang nandito sa puso niyo si Lord, if God really in your heart, you can see great miracle and destiny in your life. Praise God. And sabi ni Sister Anna kanina, i-share mo yung experience mo sa nung nag-labor ka. Praise the Lord. Talagang dumaan ko ako sa huge na labor and delivery. Is it kabed?
Kabed!
Is it kashir? Meod. Is it betesha? Shaot? Anisham. Koeb abir. Hindi ko ma-explain kung saan ba ako humugot ng lakas. Hindi ko ma-explain kung hindi ko alam kung sino ba ang tatawagan ko. But I commit everything unto the Lord, and talaga naman kahit masakit, praise the Lord, I did it.
Amen.
Praise God. At nung nakita ko si ang aking pinakamamahal na anak, is it Kamut Shibi, para bagang natulog ako. Napunta ako sa isang kadiliman. At nung nakita ko si Nathan, nakita ko yung liwanag. At liwanag na wala na yung sakit. Hindi ko alam kung paano. Ganun po. Kaya napakabuti ang Diyos sa buhay ko.
Okay, magbuntis na rin tayo.
Is it mahir?
Magbuntis
na rin
tayo.
At nung andun po ako, nagpe-Facebook pa rin ako. Kasi nga po, kung pag sumasakit na, ayun. Pero pag wala na, kinukuha ko na naman ang cellphone ko. Nag-tinox na lang, comment na naman ako. Tapos, nung mga panahon na talagang sulog-sulog na ang sakit, binibicturan pa ako. Sabi ko, Cosby! Talagang ginaganon ko na yung mga sa tabi ko. Kasi, linuloko pa nila ako na, kaya mo yan. Doming, labas ka na doming. Yung sabi ko sa kanila, huwag na kasing doming. Ayaw niyang lumabas, kaya palitan na ang pangalan. Kaya Nathan. Or Nathan. Nathan in Hebrew means a gift. Or,
Matana.
Matana Shebi. Praise the Lord. So to God be the glory. All praise is to our God alone. And without God sa buhay natin, apart from God, we can do nothing. So the lesson na gusto kong ibahagi po sa ating lahat, just trust the Lord in Proverbs. Trust the Lord with all our heart. And think that in our own understanding, and always acknowledge God, and He will direct our path. Amen. Praise God. So, to God be the glory. Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise God. To that of the Lord, to the Balabai of Sister Teresa from Ashdod. You are coming here just to witness the dedication of the son of Teresa. Thank you very much. And I know that you are still here until the food is served. Amen. So, may I welcome Nicholas Loyola, those godparents, to sign here. And after that, you are taking picture so that everything will be in order and organized.
Okay.
Okay. In the court, Sister Margie Ramil Angeles. Sister Marlene Avalos. Sister Marlene Valarin. Sir Jenny Lee Abrasado.
Thank you.